Beauty and the Beast.
Woohoo!
Hello, we are Class 401, and today we will perform Beauty and the Beast.
This story has taught us not to judge someone by how they look.
It isn't important how someone looks. It is important how well they treat others.
We also learned that it's okay if we aren't the same as other people.
As long as you are doing what is right, there is nothing wrong by being different.
We hope that you will see these lessons as well and that you enjoy our show.
Upon a time, a young prince lived in a giant castle.
One cold night, an old beggar woman came to the castle.
She offered the prince a rose in return for shelter from the cold.
The prince laughed at her gift and told her to go away.
Suddenly, the old woman changed into a beautiful enchantress.
She saw that he had no love in his heart, so she turned him into an ugly beast.
She also changed the castle servants into enchanted objects.
She left him with the rose that she offered him before.
For the spell to be broken, he would have to learn to love another and earn their love in return.
But if he did not do this before the last petal of the rose fell, he will remain a beast forever.
In a small village nearby, there lived a beautiful young woman named Belle. She loved to read books, even though some people thought that was strange.
Good morning, Belle.
Good morning.
Where are you going?
The bookshop. I just finished an amazing book about a giant and a beanstalk and...
That's nice. Marie, where's the bread? Hurry up!
There she goes. That girl is really strange.
I know, her nose is always stuck in a book.
Good morning.
Good morning, Belle. Sorry, today didn't have new books in for you.
That's okay. Can I borrow my favorite book again?
The one you already read twice? You know that if you like it so much, you can keep it.
Thank you so much.
Look, LeFou, there she is, the girl I'm going to marry.
The inventor's daughter?
Yeah, she's the only one in the town who is as beautiful as me.
You deserve the best, Gaston.
Gaston is so dreamy.
He's so cute, I can't hardly breathe.
He's tall and strong and so handsome. Belle, it's time for you to get your head off of this book and start focusing on more important things like me.
I have to get home to help my father.
Your father is a crazy old fool.
He needs all the help he can get.
Talk about my father that way.
You don't talk about your father that way.
My father is not crazy. He's a genius.
Belle thought that Gaston was a very rude man.
She did not like how he was mean to her father, Maurice.
She believed her father was a great inventor and she loved him very much.
Hello, Papa. What are you doing?
I'm getting my invention ready to take to the fair.
I am sure that you will win first prize. Papa, people in town say that I am strange.
You're not strange, and it is okay to be different from other people.
As long as I'm being a nice person, right?
Exactly, just like I taught you.
Thank you. Hey, I made you this scarf for good luck.
Thank you. Now I'm sure to win. Bye-bye, Belle.
Goodbye, Papa. Be safe.
But on his way to the fair, Maurice got lost in the wood.
He was attacked by wolf and dropped his scarf as he ran away.
He found a big castle and ran inside.
It was a beast castle, and he was angry that Maurice had come in without asking.
So the beast locked Maurice up in a tower.
Gaston saw he was better than everyone else.
He knew the bell was going to be decided to marry someone as amazing as him. This is her lucky day.
It can't be true.
Why would you do that?
Oh, Gaston, say it isn't so.
It's true. I'm going to ask Bill to marry me.
Wow.
This is the day your dream come true.
I don't think you know what my dreams are.
Bill, will you marry me?
Oh, I don't think so, but thanks for asking. Where did you get that scarf?
I found it in the woods.
This is my father's scarf. He must be in trouble.
I will make Bill my wife.
Gaston was very angry that Belle said no to him.
His friend tried to make him feel better by seeing how great he is.
Who does she think she is? Nobody said no to Gaston!
Would you like some more tea?
Nothing helps. I'm so embarrassed.
Who? You? Never! Everyone wants to be you, Gaston.
Yes, everyone admire you because...
No! Wrestling match,
nobody fights against them, for there's no one as curly and brawny.
As you see, I've got biceps to spare.
Not a bit of it's scrawny or scrawny.
That's right, and every last inch of me's covered with hair.
You know what hits like Gaston, matches wits like Gaston. In a spitting match, nobody spits like Gaston.
I'm especially good at expectorating. Tui!
Take one for Gaston! No!
Goes tromping around wearing boots like Gaston.
I use antlers in all of my decorating.
My, what a guy that Gaston!
Belle went looking for her father and found the castle. The servant who had been turned into household object was very exciting to see her.
If the beast and her could fall in love with each other, it would break the spell.
Why did you let that man come in?
You knew the master was going to be angry.
I didn't want to let the wolves eat him.
I was only trying to be nice.
Hello? Is anyone here? Papa, are you here?
It's
a girl!
You won't believe what I saw.
All right, Chip, what is it?
There is a girl in your castle.
That would be nice, but you shouldn't make up stories.
Mrs. Potts, did you hear? There is a girl in the castle.
See? I told ya.
Maybe she can break the spell.
Papa!
Belle, you need to go in safe here.
I'm the master of this castle. You must leave here.
Please, let my father go free. Take me instead.
You would take his place? Fine, take me to town.
No!
You didn't even let me say goodbye.
Master, maybe you can give her a nicer place to stay.
I'll show you your room.
Invite her to dinner.
You will join me for dinner.
I'm not hungry.
Try not to lose your temper, said Pup. Pup.
Please.
No, thank you.
Fine, if you don't eat with me, you don't eat at all.
Well, that didn't go so well, did it?
Belle was very sad, so the servant of the castle tried to make her feel better.
Belle was very surprised to see that this household after were alive.
Hello, would you like some tea?
But your
Mrs. Potts, dear, pleased to meet you.
Oops, careful, darling.
This is impossible.
I know, but here we are.
Hi, I'm Cosworth, and this is Lumiere.
If there is anything we can do to make you more comfortable, just let us know. Anything at all.
I'm a little hungry.
But not let anything else.
Cosworth, she's not our prisoner. She's our guest.
Fine, but be quiet or the master will be angry.
Of course,
but what is dinner without a little music?
Music?
Be our guest,
be our guest, put our service to the test. Tie your neck and round your neck, shall we yet provide the rest? Soup to your heart or dirt, why we only live to serve. Try the great stuff, it's delicious, don't believe me, that's a delicious. Be frank, blue, chain souffle, high and bloody on top of it. We'll prepare and serve the flair of gluten-free cabaret. No law and no scare, but the battle's all to care. No one's gloomy or complaining, while the flatware's entertaining. We tell jokes, try to tricks, with my fellow jangle sticks.
Look, it's all in perfect taste, and you can dance.
Come on and lift your
it's fine dining, we suggest.
Be our guests, be our guests, be our guests.
Be our guests.
Be our guests. Be our guests. Be our guests. Be our guests. Be our guests. Be our guests.
Over time, the servant thought the beast to be nice and kind.
Belle and the beast become very good friends.
The master wants to give Belle something nice. Let me see. What do you girls like? He can give her flowers or chocolate or money. Girls love money.
No, no, no. He needs to give her something special. Something she will be really interested in. I know.
Your master has a nice surprise for you today.
He has changed so much. He is nice and kind now.
Yes,
we all can see that he really cares about you.
You are going to want to wear something special today. Come here.
It looks amazing. I love it.
Very beautiful indeed. Now it's time to go see your surprise.
Say something about her dress.
Your dress is yellow.
No, say something nice about her dress.
Your dress looks good.
Thank you.
Belle, I want to give you something. This library is for you.
Really? It is wonderful. Thank you so much.
I knew it would work.
But what works?
Isn't it exciting?
What exciting? I don't get it.
Shh. Quiet, Chip.
Tale as old as time. True as it can be. Barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least. Both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast. Ever just the same, ever a surprise, ever as before, ever just as sure as the sun will rise. Tale as old as time, tune as old as song. Bittersweet and strange, finding you can change, learning you are wrong. Certain as the sun, rising in the east, tale as old as time, song as old as rhyme, beauty and the peace.
Are you happy here with me?
Yes, but I missed my father. I would like to see him again.
Then go to him. I will let you be free.
I am free. Thank you.
Beast let Belle go. Even though it might mean he will never be human again.
Belle ran home to see her father.
Belle!
It's all right, Papa. I am home.
How did you escape from the Beast?
I didn't escape. He let me go. He has changed.
Maurice really is crazy. He is talking about that makeup beast now.
He is not crazy. The beast is real. No, he is nice and kind. He is my friend.
It sounds like you have feeling for this monster.
You are more of a monster than he is, Gaston.
She is crazy too. This beast is too dangerous. We have to kill it.
No.
Gaston was jealous that Belle cared about the beast and not him.
So he went to the castle to kill the beast.
Belle ran to the castle and looked for the beast on the roof.
Beast, Beast, where are you?
Belle, you came back.
Yes, I came to warn you. Gaston!
Ha! Belle is mine now!
At least I got to see you the last time.
Please don't leave me. I love you.
Belle, it's me.
It is you.
had broken the spell, and they all lived happily ever after.
Yeah, come on. Yeah, we are guest, guest.
Fine dining, we suggest.
Be our guest, be our guest, be our guest.
Yeah, yeah, come on.
Be our guest.
Be our guest.